This is where I belong. Beneath the clear white blue here, I feel completely new here in the world above. It's like my life was wrong, and somehow now at last I'm in my somehow calling to me from this strange new world above.
Steady as she goes, windward ho!
A ship!
And it's heading to starboard, he blows.
Great sailor, beware,
signs
of big
unto ruin. Mysterious fathoms below, fathoms below, below. From whence wayward westerlies blow, where Triton is king and his merpeople sing in mysterious fathoms below.
Isn't this perfection, Grimsby? Out here where the seas meet the sky, surrounded by nothing but water.
Oh, yes. It's simply delightful.
The salt in your skin and the wind in your hair and the waves as they ebb and they blow. We're miles from the shore and guess what? I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave ho! Why, that's nautical nonsense. Nothing but a superstition. You've got to get back to court to honor your father's dying wish and take up his crown.
Suppose I don't want his crown.
You forsake his kingdom? All of his treasures?
Treasures? You mean like this? Who needs it? We're eating straight out of the bottle, don't we, boys?
Yeah!
Or this? Not when we've got the sun and the moon to light our way. Or this? No thanks. I'd rather eat with my bare hands.
You're a prince. Not a common sailor.
These men are anything but common. They're free, truly free, Grimsby. They don't have to answer to anyone but the sea itself. I'd rather be a sailor than a prince any day.
This is where I belong. Everything seems more real here. Strange how at home I feel here. Tides swift flow, and when the pull is strong, I almost think I hear the sea, wild and free, calling me from fathoms below.
There it is again.
Indeed, we should.
Not while I'm captain.
beautiful.
Hey, Ariel, there you are.
Flounder.
Whoa. Freaky.
What's the matter? You've never been to the surface before?
Yeah, sure. Me and the other fish in my school, we come up here all the time.
Is that so?
Sure. We're not scared of sharks, or boats, or fishermen. What's a chum bucket? Are those for real?
You are afraid, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I'm here right now, aren't I? With you.
Flounder, you're blushing.
It's sunburn. You get it up here.
Are you flirting with me?
Gross. No, no way. But if I was.
Hey, guess what I found? It was floating in the wake of a giant ship.
Treasure?
I'll say, look. Have you ever seen anything so amazing in your entire life?
Cool. What is it?
I don't know. But I know just who to ask.
Hello, Ariel.
Scuttle, look what we found.
Oh, mule or human perpendicular, eh? I have to be an expert on that very speciality.
Can you tell us what it's for?
Oh, this is rare, ridiculously rare, and in pristine condition.
What is it?
It's a dinglehopper.
A dinglehopper?
Oh, these babies are fantabulous, absolutely indispensary. When it comes to dinglehoppers, I'm a regular encyclopedia. Say that you wanna have a hairdo like the folks, so do a bear that'll flap their wings.
Flap their wings, flap!
Ah! You'll look absolutely dandy if you use one of these handy little thingamajigs. Dinglehopper, just like so. Twirl it the way I'm twirling now. Give it a little yank, and there you go. You're what the dogs call meow. Wonderful stuff, that human stuff. Can't get enough of human stuff.
It's marvelous, stupendous.
Completely AOJ. What sounds absurd, but take my word, it's what the humans say. Got a who's mushing?
I think my what a mushmaging.
That's all you need to bring up to snuff.
Right up to snuff.
With proper dingle hopper groom, and rest assured you'll look real human.
We know, cause we know human stuff.
I give you $2 sand for it.
Scuttle, no. I'm not selling it, Scuttle. I'm saving it for my collection.
How's about a swap? I got something stupendous. Museum quality, really. Abandoned bulbous snarf blast. Second cousin to the tuba.
It makes music?
Sure thing, kid. I ain't just blowing smoke. That baby makes music so fantabulous. So absolutely marvaca.
Music? Oh no, the concert. Oh my gosh, my father's gonna kill me.
The concert was today?
I completely forgot. Thank you, Scuttle. Come on, Flounder.
You want to sell it? Call me first, you hear?
Benevolent merfolk, creatures of the deep. Today marks a special anniversary. For many years ago, on this fateful day, I inherited my father's kingdom and banished Stevich Ursula forever. And so it's time to celebrate our victory. In honor of the occasion, may I introduce our master of ceremonies.
Presenting the court composer,
Horatio Thelonious Ignatius Crustaceous Sebastian.
Morning to y'all.
So tell us, what have you in store?
I got a special song just for the occasion, and it's gonna be performed by none other than your 7 lovely daughters. I wrote this little number for my star pupil.
Who might that be?
Your youngest, Ariel. Such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice, pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such a magnificent sound since, well.
Since Her Royal Highness, may she rest in peace,
You're gonna be a proud papa, you'll see. If only she show up for rehearsals once in a while.
Let the merriment begin.
We are the daughters of Triton, great father who loves us and named us well. A quarter, a third, a Arista, Arima, Bella, and Ariel.
Apology, sire, but that girl, she's gonna be the death of me. Screaming when she should be singing.
I'm
in
trouble.
I'd
say
give her some
hope.
This time, that'd be better than that.
Honestly, Daddy, you let Ariel get away with everything.
Now, now. I love all my daughters equally.
Oh, please. It's twice as oily.
Arista's prettier than Ariel. Andrina's smarter. Alana's sweeter. Atina's, well, older. And Adela, let's face it, Daddy, you're the only male attention Adela's ever gonna get.
What have you got that Ariel doesn't?
Naked ambition and the willingness to kill.
All right. That's enough. One son, Sebastian. Was that too much to hope for?
Please, sire. Don't go pointing your pappy's trident at me.
Oops. Sorry, Sebastian.
You might go whipping up a hurricane by mistake.
Well, look what the catfish dragged in.
Daddy, forgive me, I'm so sorry.
Ariel, young lady.
I just forgot, that's all.
As a result of your careless behavior.
Careless and reckless behavior.
The entire celebration was...
ruined! Completely destroyed! This concert was supposed to be the pinnacle of my distinguished career.
Sebastian?
Now, thanks to you, I am the laughingstock of the whole kingdom.
We give him a date with a whale of a guy.
I don't sing backup for anybody.
Mama loved me best, but she's gone.
Do you mind? Ariel, please, you've been given such a gift.
I know, my mother's voice.
It's a wondrous talent, one that demands stewardship and care. So please, Ariel, for the sake of her memory.
I will, Daddy, I promise.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault, I knew it all. Seagull started going,
Seagull? Seagull? You went up to the surface again?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians. One of those humans.
They're not barbarians.
They're dangerous. Traps and harpoons. Like it or not, Ariel, you're my youngest. My baby. And so I worry about you the most.
But I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my roof, you'll obey my rules.
If you just listen to me
for once.
That's
the last time you're ever going to the surface again. Understood?
You're so unfair.
Heaven help me. She's headstrong. Willful. Stubborn as a barnacle.
Teenagers. Give them an inch and they swim all over ya.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. I was too harsh. She learned to fear me. I don't want that. She needs her mother, Sebastian, and so do I.
If only she were here, she'd know just what to say. She'd firmly and yet gently help the girl to find a way. She'd know what to forbid and what we must allow. She'd have the strength and patience that I lack somehow. Oh, what I would give to have her back. Right.
Now, now. now, sire. It's difficult, sure, but you gotta toughen up. Not melt down, for Ariel's sake. I'm telling ya, that child needs constant supervision. Someone who can watch over her and keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea. Someone to safeguard her every move.
Her every dog paddle.
Her every side stroke.
Her every dive.
And you are just the crab to do it.
What?
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
Mine? But your majesty, she's a clever mermaid. I'm just a crustacean. Surely you ought to pick someone higher up on the evolutionary scale.
Oh, mistress of the deep,
beauty of the bride.
You should have seen it. All those merfolk singing Triton's praises and cursing your name.
Declaring a national holiday.
Holiday? My blowhole!
It's the day my brother Triton got greedy, that's all. The day he stole my half of the kingdom.
To think, your very own flesh and blood.
And he double-crossed you.
His own sister.
Casting you into exile, a life of shame and unceasing solitude.
To the shadowy depths of the serpentine sea.
All right, boys, don't blow your fuses. Patience. Vengeance is a dish best served cold. And pretty soon we'll have Triton on a platter, poached with a lemon wedge. When Daddy Dear was floating on his deathbed, he divvied up the kingdom into two. I got my magic shell and half the sea as well. His trident went to... You know who his trident went to, don't you? Rain, why, it was blissfully delicious. And glamour, glitz, and style were all gone. That I want.
Felt at home here.
Home's with your family, isn't it?
What if home isn't the place you were born? What if it's a place you have to go and discover for yourself?
I'd miss you if you were gone.
You would?
Not in a dopey way. Not in a crazy, hopeless, I'm so in love, but she doesn't even know I'm alive kind of way. No, not like that at all. I gotta go.
Flounder, you're very sweet. Daddy's never even met a human, but he still thinks the worst of them. I just don't see how a world that makes such beautiful things could be so bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything. Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore. You want thingamabobs? I've got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I wanna be where the people are. I wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down a, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land they'd understand, bet they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stand and ready to know what the people know. Ask them my questions and get some answers. What's a fire and why does it? What's the word? Burn! When's it my turn? Wouldn't I love, love to explore that shore above? Out of the sea. Wish I could be part of that world.
tell me, child, you got trouble in the mind.
Sebastian!
What is all this?
It's just a few knickknacks I've collected, that's all.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. If your poor father knew about this place...
You're not going to tell him, are you, Sebastian? Please, he'd never understand.
Listen to me, Ariel. For my sake, as well as your own, it's time you kept your mind on your music. From now on, you'll have voice lessons every day. And perhaps you can take up an instrument. Something ladylike. The harp, maybe.
A ship.
Why, sure, a nice harp. Made out of driftwood. And decorated with mother of pearl... Ariel? Hello? Somebody's got to nail that girl's fins to the floor. Ariel!
On his deathbed, that I'd turn you from an errant roundabout into a proper royal, so you're fit to fill his shoes.
Now you're making me queasy.
And that's not all. I promise I'd have you married by your next birthday.
Married?
Our kingdom needs a queen.
Did you ever try to take a princess sailing? It's a joke. Their crinolines get caught in the rigging, and most of them can't even swim.
Swim, sire? Is that prerequisite?
Sure, if we go sailing. Where am I gonna find her, Grimsby? A girl that's as alive and carefree as the sea itself. Where?
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
Trust me, Grimsby. When I find the girl of my dreams, it'll hit me. Like lightning.
It's hard to say. I can't make out a heart beat.
No, look, he's breathing. Just look at him. He's so beautiful.
What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I do to see you smiling at me? Where would we walk? Where would we run? If we could stay all day in the sun, just you and me, and I will be part of your world.
Prince Eric!
Oh. On your way, kid, before we're divulged!
Get away, you filthy bear!
Prince Eric, oh Eric, you just adore making my pulse race, don't you?
Girl rescued me. She pulled me right out of the surf and she was singing.
There, there now. You took a terrible tumble, my dear boy.
That voice, I can't get it out of my head.
It's the sound of the sea, that's all.
No, I'll prove it to you. I'll find her and I'll thank her for saving my life.
You'd best come with me. A night of sleep and you'll be as good as new.
Please, you have to believe me.
You've heard too many tall tales, my dear boy.
No, she was real.
Yes, of course she was. As real as a siren, as real as a mermaid on the rocks.
Head over tails, in love.
In love?
Gee, I don't know. I didn't even know it was love until the second chorus.
You follow her everywhere.
Not anymore. Not since you tried to chase after those humans. Kill it.
I hope, I pray, you didn't just say humans.
Uh-oh.
And this new love of hers. Don't tell me.
Then don't ask me.
He's one of them.
A real human, the two-legged kind.
That is gonna be ripped. Any outside of her species.
Again, calling to me, calling to me, calling to me. Somewhere there's a girl who's like the shimmer of the wind upon the water. Somewhere there's a girl who's like the glimmer of the sunlight on the sea. Somewhere there's a girl who's like a swell of endless music. Somewhere she's singing and her song is meant for me. And her voice, it's sweet as angel sighing. And her voice, it's warm as summer sky. And that sound,
respect, sire. You've been scouring the sea for weeks. And to what end?
I vowed to find her and I will.
I've a better idea. On the eve of your 21st birthday, we'll host a marvelous ball. We'll invite countless eligible young ladies from far and wide.
I knew it.
To sing for you.
What?
A contest. Which better way to find your mysterious voice? You'll be married by sunset on that very day, just as your father decreed.
Yes, why? Yes, that's how we'll find her.
Indeed we shall. You have my way.
She's out there somewhere, I just know.
I can sense her laughter in the ripple of the waves against the shoreline. I can see her smiling in the moonlight as it settles on the sand. I can feel her waiting just beyond the pale horizon. Out a melody too lovely to withstand, and her voice is fair as tusks falling, and her voice is there as dawn steals by, pure and bright, it's always near, all day, all night, and still I hear it call.
Are. A human? You fell in love with a human?
I didn't choose it. It just
happened.
Oh, child.
I thought maybe, just maybe, you'd be happy for me for once.
Happy for you? Happy because you're gone plumb crazy now. Child, you got to get your head out of the clouds and back into water where it belongs.
But I don't belong here. I never did. I don't fit in as hard as I try. If only I could be up there instead, walking on the very same ground he is, breathing the very same air.
Down here is your home. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
You're wrong, I swear.
Believe me, child, it's true. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor.
Hello!
Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea. Under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we voted full time to flatten under the sea. Down here, all the fish is happy as off through the waves they roll.
The fish on the land ain't happy. They sad cause they in the bowl. The fish in the bowl is lucky. They get for a worser fate. One day when the boss gets hungry,
guess who gone beyond the plate?
Uh-oh.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Nobody beat us, fry us and eat us in frigates.
Under the sea.
We watch the land folks love to cook. Under the sea we off the hook. We got no troubles, life is deep bubbles. Under the
sea. Life's the bubbles under the sea. Oh.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to beat here naturally.
Under the sea.
Even the sturgeon and the ray.
Hey!
Take it to your to start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it.
Under the sea. The new play, the flute, the car play, the harp, the blaze play, the bass, and they sound in charge. The bass play, the brass, the chop play, the top. The flute gets a new cup song.
Know how to jump
under the sea.
Each little slug gear got in a rug here
under the sea.
We got a hot crustacean bun
under the sea.
Each little snail here know how to whale here. That's why it's under, under the water. Yeah, we in luck here, down in the muck here, under the sea, child. That's what I'm talking about. Are you? Hello?
Where is she, Sebastian? Where?
You just miss her. She slipped away.
To think she'd betray her family this way. That she'd turn her back on her own kind.
She can't help it, sire.
I taught her myself. And now she makes a mockery of everything we hold dear. Where is she hiding?
If only I knew.
She keeps secrets from me, Sebastian. Not from you. I'll wager you know where she is. Now take me to her.
Think this belonged to him once. He held this with his own two hands.
Ariel!
Ariel, tell the truth. Did you save a human from drowning?
Who told? Which one of you?
I'm sorry, Ariel. I'm nothing but a guppy, just a lousy guppy.
That's enough. Leave us alone. You too, Sebastian. So did you?
I had to save the prince.
You had to.
Without me, he would have perished.
She's a human. You're a mermaid.
I can't hate him just because he's different. Maybe you can, but it's just not in me.
Different? They catch us with their hooks, they spear us with their blades.
They're not all like that.
Have you forgotten what they did to your mother?
We don't know that for certain.
Can there be any doubt? She slips out one morning for an innocent swim and never returns.
But you can't prove that.
I know it in my heart and it's enough. Murderers, all of them.
You can't blame all humans for a few wicked ones.
I won't have you build a shrine to them. Worshipping their rubbish. The debris that sullies our waters.
Don't, please.
Totems of your decadence.
Daddy, no!
Never again, Ariel. Never again!
Ariel.
He ruined all my things. My human stuff. If he truly loved me, then he'd never.
Oh, child, it's because he loves you.
Well, he sure is a funny way of showing it. He can break every treasure I own, but he can't break me.
Yeah, but you might just break his heart.
And you. Some friend you turned out to be, bringing him here to my secret place.
For your own good, child. I pray you wake up from this madness, and soon. You're swimming in some dangerous waters.
If only he would look, if only he could see, could love me as I am instead of how he'd wished I'd be. He doesn't really care, he doesn't want to know. I hate him, yes, I hate him. God, I hate him so. Oh, what I would give if only I could go.
Poor child, poor sweet child. She has a very serious problem, hasn't she? If only there were something we could do.
Who are you two?
Sweet child.
Poor child.
So
misunderstood.
Dear child.
Sad child.
Life's looking,
shall we say,
not good.
No.
Well, either woes and worries.
Who will help her get her man?
Sweet child. Perhaps the sea witch can.
You can't possibly mean Aunt Ursula.
She knows your dream.
Father says her magic's evil.
She'll grant your prayer.
Please, I have to go.
She'll cast a charm.
A tiny spell.
Alarm,
no one will tell.
No one will care.
It's your affair.
Sweet child, dear child.
Poor child.
That child.
We'll bring her to her lair right now.
Bet in half a sec, your prince and you are reconciled. Together forever.
Take me to her.
Sweet child.
Hello? Ariel? It's me. Where'd you go? Ariel!
Mistress of the deep, you've a visitor.
I'm not so sure.
Now, mustn't get cold fins.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling. It's me, your Auntie Ursula.
I shouldn't be here.
Nonsense. We're family.
Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes, but he says the same thing of humans, doesn't he, Snookums? And we both know that's not true. Don't we?
Why did he banish you?
Oh, the oceans weren't big enough for the two of us. And now he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling.
We're so very alike, you and I. Gals with ambition. Nothing scares a man more. Now tell dear old auntie everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
Yes, this prince fellow. He's quite a catch. The answer is simple. You've got to become human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help you, my dear sweet child? It's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. Find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True?
Yes.
And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, the lonely, and depressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thin, or that one wants to get bigger. Like, can I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying, spells, Ursula, please, and I help them. Yes, I do. Happened once or twice, someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint. To those
human for 3 days. It's got a procedural clause, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Oh, nothing drastic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look, small print. Your soul is mine forever, and you're doomed to spend eternity in my watery, hell-soaked lair. Lawyers, don't you just love them? Now, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have anything.
Oh, I'm not asking for much, dear. Only your voice.
My voice?
Don't worry, I have the perfect place for it. Your grandpappy Poseidon gave his magic trident to your father. But this was his gift pour moi.
Your magic shell.
You've heard about it.
Father says it's the source to all your witchcraft.
Nonsense, darling.
But he said you'd die without it.
Die? Oh, please, it's bauble. Nothing but a vessel for your voice. Trust me, dear. Your vibrato, your legato, even your belt. They'll all be safe and sound right in here.
If I give my voice away, then how could I...
You'll have your looks. Your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of body language. Is a bore. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on! They're not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they dote and swoon and fawn on a lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets her man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman, and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor, unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want to cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign the scroll. Flotsam and jetsam, now I've got her, boys. The party's on a roll. You poor...
human, I'll never see my family again. My sister's not even my father.
Now, do you want Princey Poo or not? 5, 4, 3, 2...
Yes! I'll do it. Where do I sign?
Not just any ink, dear. Here's mine. Come winds of the Caspian Sea. Larynx is glossitis, had max laryngitis, la voce to me. Now sing, sing, sing your voice over to me.